It's a heart-stopping amusement park ride that played a suspenseful part in the comedy horror movie Zombieland. The Drop Tower ride recently made its way to the Philippines, but minus the flesh-eating zombies, of course. Its Philippine version is called the Extreme Tower Ride. Extreme, in this case, is spelled E-K-S-T-R-E-M-E, with the first two letters being the initials of Enchanted Kingdom.
This ride is a generic design, but it was built by a local company in Plainview, Texas. There are more than 50 of these in the States, but this is their first export model. It's very cost-effective to run, completely safe, and built to international safety standards. Well, the tower that we got is 150 feet, symbolizing 10 feet for every year that Enchanted Kingdom has been wowing the public, 15 years.
Rising up the tower is a gondola that seats 12 passengers. Each seat on the gondola is equipped with a padded over-the-shoulder restraint system. Safety belts act as secondary restraints by linking the lower portion of the over-the-shoulder bar to the seat structure. The gondola is coupled to a trolley which lifts it up the tower before disconnecting and allowing the gondola to free fall for about 2 seconds. The most important safety features of the ride are the magnetic brakes on the gondola. By working on the principle of magnetic attraction, the brakes decelerate the gondola on its way down. Two self-contained hydraulic cylinders also provide additional deceleration for the gondola before it comes to rest on the platform and is again coupled to the trolley.
It works, of course, on the principles of gravity, wherein you're winched up for about a minute to enjoy the view of Laguna, including Laguna Lake and Tagaytay. But once you get to the top of the tower, it suddenly stops, and within 2 seconds, you're back on the ground.
The entire cycle of the Extreme Tower Ride is computer-controlled, from its ascent up the tower to its sudden plunge and braking. But there's a safety backup, a specially trained operator who monitors the entire cycle of raising the gondola, its freefall, and its reconnection to the trolley.
Kailangan, sir, naka-auto lang.
Ah, okay. So ano pa ang kailangan mo i-check bago mo umpisahan yung ride? Meron ka bang safety check muna?
Yes, sir. Meron, sir, tayo na safety lock bar, sir. Kapag, sir, nakailaw, sir, means lahat, sir, ng safety buckles niya nakatang.
Okay.
Kung meron, sir, matanggal, hindi, sir, yun.
Hindi ilaw yung kulay green na
yes,
light ko?
Yes, sir. Sir, yung mag-indicate na ready for dispatch, sir.
Okay. So yun lang kailangan ko i-check, safety switch?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And then, sir, from manual, sir, kung meron man po, sir, kailangan din, sir, i-check natin ng manual. Kung talagang
and this is where the Extreme Tower Ride operator gets to put his foot down. Underneath the control panel is a foot pedal that acts as an emergency brake for the ride. Except in this case, the operator needs to first keep the pedal depressed to put the ride in motion. In an emergency, releasing the foot pedal immediately halts the ride.
Kailangan, sir, nakalock na, sir. Double check natin kung talagang nakalock talaga, sir. Pero ito, sir, yung nag-i-indicate na ready na, sir.
Unfortunately, my problem with vertigo, yes, vertigo, and not any affinity to a feathered barnyard animal, didn't allow me to get on the Extreme Tower Ride, or many other Enchanted Kingdom rides for that matter. But my ever-fearless executive producer and child at heart, Dino Ponte-Urig, eagerly volunteered to be among the first to try the Extreme Tower even before it was officially open to the public. Dino also volunteered to videotape himself, just to have the added pleasure of seeing his own gleeful facial reaction to being plummeted at 47 miles per hour from a height of 150 feet. The thrills don't end here at the Extreme Tower Ride. Future Perfect will show you more of the tech that goes into the exciting attractions at the Enchanted Kingdom.